Or now he says
I think, honestly, I mean, the goal of the Republican health care reform has never really been about the uninsured, right? I mean, that's not, they've been explicit about that it's about what they call access to health care. So I don't know how much that number actually affects them. It's in line with what the House bill was. So while it may, you know, look bad, and I think they will pay a price for it down the road, I don't know that it would keep them from voting. I think what is going to be the problem for them is what David brought up, which is that the people who are, the only people who will see their premiums go down under this are young people. And I think that that's a real miscalculation on their part. If you have people, you know, 60 and older seeing their rates go up, sometimes, you know, by really astronomical rates, by 5 times what they were already paying, I think that there would be a real political price to pay for that.
Yeah, of course, they say all politics is local. There's no more local issue. There's no more issue that is more tactile for voters than health care, really. When you think people are going to notice that, they're going to notice what their premiums are, they're going to notice if they don't suddenly have insurance. How does the Republican Party make that work for them?
Right. Well, I firmly believe that the way that people are experiencing the health care system will have a far greater impact on their voting than any ad they see on television. And Republicans have done quite well in the last number, especially the last two midterm elections, by talking about how bad they say Obamacare was. This has been an issue that Republicans feel has been politically beneficial to them, at least up until this point, which makes the politics so much more interesting now that Republicans kind of own it. If Republicans pass a bill and people feel like their health care has not gotten better, I believe they will punish Republicans. On the other hand, if this bill does all the great things that Republicans say it will, then they'll benefit. I don't think that a CBO report will change things nearly as much as if voters, say those elderly voters, find their premiums going up, or if younger voters suddenly love the GOP because their premiums have gone down.
David Chalian, as you look at those senators, I mean, of course, you have a mix here because some want it to go further, right? And some think it goes too far. But as you look at those five names, plus we have the others in the kind of on the fence category, who do you think is most likely to move or not move? And I know this is a little bit of political tea leaf reading.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think all five of those senators are in the same category, right? Some of them, I believe, let's say like Ted Cruz or Mike Lee, might be publicly negotiating here, trying to express early opposition so that then they get something to go back home with and say, I pushed this bill to the right, I got a more conservative solution. Dean Heller, I think, is a different case here. I mean, here's the most politically imperiled Republican up for re-election going against the bill, now facing the potential wrath of a pro-Trump super PAC for doing so, sort of an intra-party fight among Republicans. But he clearly looks at the politics of this, stands with his Republican governor, and says, this is going to hurt Nevadans. I can't get there in this version of the bill. I don't see anything in this report today or in the reports of how the bill may be changing slightly that would all of a sudden allow Dean Heller to join forces with the president and help push it through.
Understood. Well, of course, the other big headline today is the Supreme Court's decision on the travel ban, something of a decision, allowing parts of it to stay in place, while at the same time saying that the full court's going to take it up in the fall. We also have Jeffrey Toobin with us. He knows the issues behind this. Jeffrey Toobin, first of all, were you surprised by this ruling? And what does it mean for the travel ban going forward?
Well, I was a little surprised because the court obviously did more than just decide to review the case. They modified the stay that had been in effect in I think a rather clever way. What the court said is that the blanket travel ban from the six Muslim countries, Muslim majority countries, is not in effect anymore. But the people who have a bona fide connection to the United States, who have relatives here, who have a job offer here, who are admitted students here, they can come in. So the stay does not apply to them. So strangers, tourists can't come in from the Muslim majority countries, the six countries, but people with a connection to the United States can come in. And that strikes me as an interesting compromise, and it is certainly a better result for the Trump administration than it's had from any of the Court of Appeals so far. So certainly this is a better day for the Trump administration and the Supreme Court.
Let me ask you this. Were you surprised that there was no dissent from the more liberal side of the court to kind of teeing up for that they're going to vote against it in the full court in the fall?
Well, you know, that's an interesting question, but I actually am not that surprised, because, but well, I have been surprised as how tough the courts have been on the travel ban so far. You know, I've always thought that the Supreme Court was going to be a much more receptive audience to the Trump administration than the lower courts. And it is worth noting that the three of the more conservative justices, Justice Alito, Justice Thomas and Justice Gorsuch, they all said they would leave the entire travel ban in place. So they look like three certain votes in favor of the Trump administration when the court hears the merits of the case in October. So all it looks like the Trump administration needs is to find two more votes, and that's, I think, fairly likely. So I think the Trump administration's looking pretty good going forward in winning this case. So I think, by and large, it was definitely a good day for the Trump administration and the Supreme Court regarding the travel ban.
Well, big news today on the CBO health care bill, but also on the travel ban. Thanks to my panel here in Washington, Jeff Toobin in New York as well.